They say imitation is the best form of flattery, and by that account, Sree Saravana Bhavan is right up there. When you drive on the highway, especially NH75, NH7, from Bangalore towards Salem, you will find at least half a dozen Saravana Bhavan, but they aren't the real thing. So today we've stopped for breakfast at the Krishnagiri outpost of Sree Saravana Bhavan. So let's go in and check out what a breakfast at Sree Saravana Bhavan is all about. So of course at Saravana Bhavan here, it's a vegetarian restaurant, and in addition to South Indian, they also serve a smattering of North Indian and Chinese, but that's not what we are here for. We are here to check out the South Indian breakfast. So let's try and find out what's really popular here. Also a chance to use some broken Tamil. Inge breakfast la yen nalla irukku.
Idli Vada, Pongal, Rava Kichadi, Dosa items, Puri, Appam, Idiyappam. Dosa item, plain dosa, Masala Dosa, Ghee dosa, Rava dosa, PODI DOSA, onion rava masala, onion uttapam, masala roast.
So oru Idli Vada, oru PODI DOSA, oru Pongal, oru Idiyappam.
Thank you.
So my Idli Vada is here already, and what I really like is that, you know, the accompaniments that it comes with. So the Idli Vada comes with some onion chutney, some tomato onion chutney, some coconut chutney of course, also the podi and the sambar. You hold an idli like this, you know that it's light and fluffy. You can see that the idli is almost, is so light, it's almost sagging under the, under all that fluffiness. So in Tamil Nadu, you'll always find that the sambar is thick. You can actually taste the lentil goodness in the sambar. Now this idli is soft. The idli is soft and fluffy, almost pillowy. Let's get some of it into the sambar. You can also taste that tart edge of the idli, which I think is the effect of fermentation and of course the temperature in Tamil Nadu. I taste a bit of the other chutney as well. So this is the onion chutney. So it's got this tangy sort of a flavor. This is the tomato onion chutney. Here you get a bit of the sweetness that also comes in from the tomato, which is quite nice actually. You can see some flecks of chili. You can see some pepper. Let's taste the vada just by itself. You can hear the crunch. Mouthful but delicious. So the pongal is here studded with some lovely toasted cashew and of course also the curry leaf. I can also see the goodness of ghee around the edge. Delicately tempered, so the spices in the pongal are very light and very mellow. It tastes a lovely flavor of the curry leaf and the cashew. Very delicate in terms of its flavor, and you just have that slight peppery bite of the peppercorn. Very nice. So I've got my masala dosa here. You know, the masala dosa in Tamil Nadu is very different from the masala dosa that you find in Karnataka. I think one of the things that you always find is that the dosa here tends to be much thinner and I think more on the crisper side. I think in Karnataka the dosas are slightly thicker, both delicious in their own right. You know, I can taste the crunch of the dosa in my mouth as I'm eating it. This is a Tamil Nadu masala dosa, a dosa which is very, very thin. That's what you find. The other thing which is nice here is that the oil is very sparingly used. So if you look at this dosa and you look at my fingers, there's not as much oil. The potatoes here is almost like a paste. So when you taste the dosa with the sambar, you still have the savoriness of the lentils. If you were to taste a masala dosa in Karnataka with the sambar, you will get a bit of the sweet edge. Both delicious, but very different. Okay. Slight change in scene now. So I've got the masala dosa here, and now I have a podi dosa. Now this podi dosa looks very similar to the masala dosa, but that's really where the similarity ends. You can taste the fire of the podi. So the podi is basically a Tamil Nadu staple, so which is basically lentils with some chili powder, with some garlic, and all of that goes together to make this spicy condiment. Mmm. To be honest, it's a little too spicy for me. So I'm a bit surprised to find this dish here, because this dish is not really a Tamilian dish. So this is a Malayali dish, idiyappam. And this idiyappam is served with some coconut milk. Sweet. Oh, delicious. You can taste a bit of that cardamom that's been used to flavor the coconut milk. Savory korma on the side. Usually they serve this with a kadala. You can taste the coconut, you can taste mellow sweetness of the coconut, you can taste the cardamom that's been used to flavor this. Such a simple dish, but rich in its flavors, rich in its depth of flavors. Mm. Needless to say, I've overeaten, and what I really need after all those dishes is this nice cup of coffee. Ah. And again, this is one of those things that you will find different. The coffee in Tamil Nadu versus the coffee in Karnataka. I find that the roast in Tamil Nadu tends to be a little deeper, and you definitely taste a little more body in the coffee. Perfect. Hope you enjoyed this video. Subscribe and stay tuned to Food Lovers TV for more episodes from Gourmet on the Road. And do leave a comment below to tell me what you thought of this episode. Happy eating!